हम अलीगर लिंगप्पा असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन फिजिक्स गवर्नमेंट फर्स्ट ग्रेड कॉलेज सिरगुप्पा आर टुडेस माय चैप्टर इज इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट सो नाउ आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट ए टॉपिक सो कॉल्ड इंटरफेरेंस एट एन एयर ब्रिज सो दिस इज नॉट ए थ्योरी टॉपिक सो डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ थिकनेस ऑफ object say paper or any other material by the experiment so called interference at an air bridge. So then for the study of determination of thickness of given paper by using interference at an air bridge setup. So, what are the experimental arrangements we must require? Then, what are the apparatus required? How they can be arranged? What about the experimental procedure? Then, how the result which can be obtained? Then, what about the formula we have used in this experiment? That means now I will discuss all those things. So first come to the point, aim of the experiment. To determine the thickness of the given paper by setting up interference at an air bridge. Then the apparatus required. So first traveling microscope. Two identical optically plain rectangular glass plates. Stand with a turning glass plate, meter scale, sodium vapor lamp. So these are the equipments we must need to arrange the air bridge experiment for the determination of thickness of the given paper. So just as the air wedge diagram, so lengthwise beam, there are two optically flats, that means glass plates, then both they are binding with the rubber at one of its ends, one of their ends. Then a thin wire or a thin paper of uniform thickness D is placed between the two surfaces of the glass plates, flat glass plates. So let L be the length of the air wedge. So that means the air wedge which consists of two glass plates. They are separated by a thin narrow paper or wire of uniform thickness. Then the air film will be formed between the upper surface of the lower glass plate and the lower surface of the upper glass plate. So then the thickness of the air medium goes on, increases from left to right. So this is what about the air bridge. So this, now is the experimental arrangement. So the experimental arrangement which consists of a sodium vapor lamp. The light, that means from the sodium vapor lamp, monochromatic light, is made to incident on the glass plate, say inclined glass plate, is called turnable glass plate, which can be inclined at an angle of 44 degrees. Then the parallel beam of light incident on the glass plate, which gets reflected and moves vertically downwards, and is made to incident on the upper glass plate of the air vent, and then the light, vertical beam of light, is incident on the air film. The part of light reflected from the upper surface of the air film, the part of light transmitted through the air film. Again, at the lower surface of the air film, where the light which undergoes both reflection and transmission. Again, at that point, the part of light which gets reflected. The rays of light reflected from the upper surface of the air film and the lower surface of the air film, they derived from a single incident ray. They have the same wavelength, the same amplitude, same frequency, constant phase difference. They are called coherent waves. If they are superposed to each other, then they are forming the alternating bright and dark fringes based on the principle of superposition of waves, so-called interference pattern. The interference pattern, which consists of alternating bright and dark fringes, the interference pattern which can be viewed with the help of a traveling microscope. So that the interference pattern which obtained in case of air vent experiment, the optical flares and the turnable glass plate in the stand we wiped clean by a soft cloth. The given piece of paper is cut into a narrow strip with a straight parallel edges. The two flares are kept one on the other with a edge to edge alignment. Between two flares, the paper strip is inserted at one end, and such that the strip's inner edge is parallel to the shorter edge of the flares. The other end of the glass plates are bound together by means of a thin tape or rubber band. This unit gives rise to an air vent in the space between the two flares, space between the two glass plates. So this is what about the construction of air vent by using two glass plates and then the thin paper, a strip and a rubber band or tape. The air vent unit is kept in the stand below the tinting glass plate, below the turnable glass plate. The stand is placed below the microscope of the traveling microscope, such that the mid part of the wedge is below the objective and its long edge parallel to the scale in the traveling microscope. The sodium lamp which is switched on. The turnable glass plate in the lens is adjusted by rotation of a forward inclination of 44 degrees with respect to the direction of the incident light, at which the time field of view in the microscope becomes bright. The microscope is then focused by vertical movement to obtain the clear view of the fringes will be seen. The high piece is then rotated to align the longitudinal crosswise parallel to the fringes. So what I said earlier, when a vertical lines, if they are vertical, that means parallel beam of light, if it met incident vertically on the air wedge, the part of light reflected from the lower surface and the part of light reflected from the upper surface of the air wedge. So due to the superposition of those two rays, we will get the interference fringes. Then the interference pattern, which can be viewed with the help of traveling microscope, eyepiece of the travel microscope, with the help of the rotated screw, where the crosswire, which can be coincide with any one of the fringes. Then by turning the head scale drum in any one direction, two or three rotations are completed and it is stopped when the longitudinal crosswire is set against any one of the dwarf fringes. The ordinal number of this fringe is designated as zero. The readings of traveling microscope for this position is noted. Turning the head scale of drum in the same direction as earlier always, the readings for only the dwarf fringes of even ordinal numbers are noted, ignoring the intermediate dwarf fringes. That means the crosswire of the traveling microscope is coincide with any one of the fringes, any one of the dwarf fringes. Say the fringe, that fringe is signified or denoted by zero. Then note down the corresponding traveling microscope reading, TM reading. That means mesoscale reading, CVD, and then by using the formula TR is equal to MSR plus CVD into LC, by substituting the values of MSR, CVD and LC, then you calculate what about the total reading for a zeroth fringe. And then further, again the head scale drum is rotated in any one direction, maybe right or left, till the crosswire which moves when it crosses two fringes, then again the crosswire is coincide for the second fringe. Then note down the corresponding MSR, CVD and readings. Then calculate total reading for a second dwarf fringe. Similarly, we will take MSR and CVD readings for even number of dwarf fringes. That means first one is zeroth fringe, second a second fringe, then a fourth dwarf fringe, sixth dwarf fringe, 8th dwarf fringe and then a 10th dwarf fringe. Then a corresponding MSR reading, corresponding CVD, then calculate the total reading TR with the help of the equation TR is equal to MSR plus CVD into LC. Then the readings are entered into the tabular column from which the width of 10 fringes and hence the width of one fringe, that is beta, is evaluated for 5 pairs of readings whose ordinal number differences is 10, then a mean value of beta is found. By using a graduated ruler, the length of wedge L is found by measuring the distance between the inner edge of the paper and at the end of the wedge, where the optical glass plates are in contact. The thickness of the given paper is then found by using the formula given below. D is equal to lambda L by 2 beta, where lambda, that means the wavelength of yellow color, the wavelength of sodium vapor lamp. So lambda is equal to 5893 × 10⁻⁻¹ meter, 5893 angstrom. Then by substituting the values of lambda, then L, the length of the hair bed, which can be determined with the help of the Hardiner scale, then a beta, so which can be obtained by the experiment. Then substituting all those values in that expression, then determine what about the thickness of the thin paper strip. So then they finally result the thickness of the paper, thickness of the given paper is found to be dash, say right in meter. So formula we have used in this experiment, D is equal to lambda L by 2 beta, where D, that indicate the thickness of the paper. Then lambda is the wavelength of sodium light, so 5893 × 10⁻¹⁰ meter. L is the length of the wedge, then beta is the mean fringe width, width of a single fringe. Then what about the least count of Travelling microscope? Least count of Travelling microscope, which is equal to the ratio of value of 1 MST by total number of EST. Then note down the value of 1 MSD, then they note down the total number of VST from the Travelling microscope, then substituting in this expression, in this formula, then calculate whatever the least count of the Travelling microscope. So usually the least count of Travelling microscope, which is in the order of 0.001 centimeter. Then the total reading, which can be determined with the help of the equation TR is equal to MSR plus CVD into LC, where MSR main scale reading, then CVD coinciding vernier scale reading, and LC into LC means a least count. Then what about the observations? Measurements of the length of the wedge L by using ordinary scale, distance between the point of the optical glass piece and the inner edge of the paper, say L is equal to some, say maybe it may be 4 to 5 centimeter. Then what about the readings we will take with the help of Travelling microscope, that means from the main scale and the vernier scale. So all they are entering here, that means in this tabular column. So here the tabular column, first column, which is a fringe ordinal number, usually 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Usually we will take the readings for even fringes, even number of fringes. Then the reading of TM, that means reading of Travelling microscope, MSR reading in centimeter, CVD, which has no unit, then calculate total reading, then right here, that means all the readings are noted here, that means in the tabular column, MSR reading, CVD, and then the total reading. Again, for the fringes 10, 12, 14, 16, and 18, again you take the Travelling microscope reading, MSR reading, CVD, then calculate, find total reading TR is equal to MSR plus CVD into LC, then substituting here, that means tabulated here. Then width of 10 fringes, say R2 difference R1. Say what about the total reading which obtained for the 10th fringe and the 0th fringe, the difference of those two gives the width of 10 fringes. So similar for 12th fringe and 2nd fringe, similarly for 14th fringe and 4th fringe, similarly the difference between 16th fringe and 6th fringe, similarly the difference between 18th and 8th fringes. Then we will get the width of 10 fringes for 10:0, 12:2, 14:4, 16:6, 18:8. Then you take the meaning of all those things, the width of, then calculate the width of a single fringe. That means width of one fringe. So called beta is equal to R2 difference R1 by 10. Where R2 difference R1, that means the mean of all the readings. The mean of five readings. Then R2 minus R1 by 10, that gives mean fringe width. Then how the thickness of the paper that can be determined. So here the measured values are L is equal to, that means the length of the hair width, which is equal to centimeter, which can be converted into meter, say 10^(-2 meter. Then a fringe width, you take mean fringe width, beta is equal to centimeter, then the is converted into a meter, say 10^(-2 meter. And the wavelength of sodium light is given, say lambda is equal to 5, 8, 9, 3 to 10^-10 meter. That means 5,893 angstrom. Then the thickness of the paper strip, so to be determined with the help of this equation. So D is equal to lambda L by 2 beta. By substituting the value of lambda, the value of L, the value of beta, in that expression, in that equation, then calculate or find the thickness of the paper strip. So the thickness of the paper strip, D is equal to, so write here in terms of meter. Then finally, you can write the result of this experiment. So the thickness of the given paper strip is found to be is equal to a dash, so in meters. So in this class, we discussed about what is air width, how the air width can be set up, then what about the hair width experiment, what about the arrangement of the experimental arrangement, so then procedure of the experiment, then how the thickness of the strip, so which can be determined, and so on. Thank you.